Even in death, everything comes with a price. The casket, the headstone, and if there's reason to investigate what happened, the autopsy. But you might be surprised by what the WDSU I team found when we went price shopping at the coroner's office.
Dr. Mignard's numbers certainly are striking.
That's because one coroner is charging cut rates while doing 3 and 4 times the amount of work as his counterparts.
Tonight, I-Team reporter Travis Mackle is live with why some say that's a raw deal for everyone who pays taxes in Orleans Parish. Travis?
Camille, some experts in the field of forensic medicine say the price Orleans Parish coroner Dr. Frank Mignard is charging for autopsies is suspect, and the big loser in the end is me and you, and possibly the citizens who've lost loved ones.
For hundreds of New Orleanians, every year, this is the final stop on life's journey, a nondescript, often overburdened facility in the heart of Central City, the New Orleans Forensic Center. It's where every autopsy in Orleans Parish is performed by members of the coroner's office, and it's a place not without controversy. Just over a year ago, the I-team detailed a lawsuit against the man in charge, Dr. Frank Mignard. His accuser, a man named Joe Dragousis, claimed the coroner's office had misclassified the death of his son. The matter is still under litigation. There has been no judgment. But it's not the only criticism the 83-year-old Mignard has faced. His office came under scrutiny in 2009 for its handling of a deadly police shooting. You may remember the name, Adolph Grimes. He was shot 14 times, mostly in the back, but the case was not deemed a homicide.
It begs the question.
Critics have maintained for years that there are problems within the coroner's office, where Dr. Mignard has served since 1974. And now the I-team has new numbers that some say are simply shocking.
Dr. Mignard's numbers certainly are striking.
The National Association of Medical Examiners recommends each pathologist perform at most 250 autopsies a year. That, experts say, helps ensure the quality of work. The Orleans Parish coroner employs 4 full-time medical examiners, which would mean a best practices cap each year of 1,000 autopsies. But records obtained by the I-team show those forensic pathologists exceed the maximum standard every year in 2010, 11, and 12. As many as 1,300 autopsies annually. Not surprisingly, it makes Orleans Parish the busiest coroner's office in the state by far, even though the parish ranks 3rd in population. In fact, you can take the total number of autopsies performed in 2011 and 2012 in Louisiana's largest 2 parishes, Jefferson and East Baton Rouge, combine the figures, and they still amount to less than half of what Dr. Mignard's office does. By law, coroners are only legally responsible to perform autopsies in cases of homicides, suicides, and suspicious deaths. New Orleans' homicide problem is well documented, with anywhere from 175 to just under 200 killings annually in recent years. So what accounts for all those additional examinations?
To indicate that there would be 1,000 suspicious deaths that would require an autopsy would seem to approach an upper limit in almost anyone's category.
But not to Dr. Mignard, who's been the coroner for 39 years.
There's so much litigation going on in the world, so much. Every death is questioned.
Why 1,300? Autopsies in 2011 and 2012.
Over the years, more people are dying, and so we've had to do more autopsies.
And the work Mignard's staff does reaches far outside of Orleans Parish. Records show his pathologist performed autopsies in 2011 and 2012 on about 900 people who died in New Orleans. An additional 400 autopsies are routinely performed each year for other parishes in the state. Parishes as far away as Madison and Wynn in North Louisiana. It's not uncommon for larger parishes to perform autopsies for smaller ones, but those added exams mean extra work for what appears to be an already taxed staff. And what is uncommon? The price Dr. Mignard charges. He confirmed to the WDSU I-team something we were surprised to discover, that outside parishes pay $300 per autopsy.
And then I can do the recommendation.
It's a figure that's caught the attention of several other coroners.
I don't know how you do an autopsy for $300. The cost that we have generated for our program, our regional autopsy program, is a direct cost analysis. It's what the autopsy costs.
Dr. Bo Clark is the coroner in East Baton Rouge Parish. Like Minyard's office, his staff handles out-of-parish autopsies. The East Baton Rouge office did 25 last year. For each of those, Clark's office, as well as the forensic labs in Jefferson and Caddo parishes, charged north of $1,000. That's more than three times what Minyard bills for out-of-parish autopsies.
If you look at the real number, it is. It's about $1,100, I guess, at the end of the day, is what an autopsy should cost to do that.
How do you do it for $300 when most of them charge north of $1,000?
Well, I think, we're trying to serve the common man here. And I think that the $300 is enough. It covers our expenses.
But it's also costing the city. If Dr. Minyard charged $1,000 for each out-of-parish autopsy, like other forensic labs, he could generate almost an additional $300,000 for his office each year. Money that could be well spent, considering Dr. Minyard stores bodies in trucks like these outside his office, and the city has yet to break ground on a new, hoped-for forensic center at Earhart Boulevard.
Would it be wiser to charge more for these autopsies for the financial stability of your office?
Practicing medicine is not something you can put a price on.
I don't know how the Orleans and the $300 thing is even working. I'm not sure. If they've got a magic formula that they can do it for cheaper and it's legitimate, I'm sure a lot of the parishes around here would love to know what that is. So we could implement it, but I don't believe that to be the case.
Neither does Chuck Credo, who expects the New Orleans City Council, the people who control the coroner's purse strings, to be asking a lot of questions.
Well, I think a city council would want to know the accounting trail of all monies that the coroner gets.
So Travers, a riveting report. Question though, how does Dr. Minyard do an autopsy for so little, or are we finding that others are overcharging?
It's a good question. We spoke with a number of experts in this field beyond those that you saw in this report, and they all came back to that $1,000 figure. Every one of them tells us there's no way to conduct a legitimate autopsy for $300. Here's an example. Dr. Bo Clark says if he does a toxicology test on a body, that alone cost $250. That's without doing anything else. And if you or I tried to hire a pathologist to conduct a private examination, it would cost, in most cases, north of $3,000.
Wow.
An enlightening investigation.
Thanks.
Travers. Thank you. More on this story coming up.